Yeah, this is what you have to understand in this concept. What we learned, the parallel of Brahma, and what he is trying to confuse us while giving the question, while framing the question like this. So you should not leave the basics, Nana. What I said, while applying the parallelogram law of vectors mod r bar is equals to root of a square plus b square plus 2ab cos theta. I think here it is correct. Under the diagram, what I wrote, it is correct. Excuse me. What is the basic condition here? While applying this formula, you have to see whether the given two vectors are originated from the same point or not. That you have to check. If both are originated from the same point, happily you can use the formula. Okay. But here, look at, they are in order, not originated from the same point. This is in order. They are originated from the same point. Okay. So this is the difference. So to apply this formula, we have to take them as originated from the same point. Originated from the same point means what must I do here? Shift. Yes, exactly. This one is to be shifted like this, parallelly to this position. Exactly. Shift parallel. Then these two are looking like originated from the same point, like A bar is shifted to here. Okay. So this is B bar, and the angle here, 180 minus 5. Exactly. Here the angle, if you ask me, I write angle between the two vectors. Usually we take it as theta. Theta is equals to 180 minus 5. So small modification I have to do here. What cos theta, in place of theta, what I suppose to write there? 180 minus 5. Right, cos 180 minus 5. Means you are getting there like root of, yes, exactly. Root of a square plus b square minus 2ab cos 5 you will get. Am I right, Nana? Cos 180 minus 5 is minus cos 5. So a square plus b square minus 2ab cos 5. Okay. Take care, Nana. This is one model. So don't get confused. If they are given in order and the angle between them is given, sir. Okay. No need to stretch your hands. Okay. Simple. Use this formula. Okay. And here. Yes. Yeah, sure, Nana. And then here, this is another point. This is a common point. But when they are originated from the same point. So two different models here. So if they give the angle between them while originating, happily you can use yesterday's form. If the angle between them given like in order, then just to do a small modification, that's it. Okay. And here you already noted one point. Here the angle, there the angle, sum of these two angles is 180. Means theta plus phi, already you recognize, it is 180 degrees. Okay? Yeah. Then once you check back your parallelogram, Nana, here, such kind of condition you will get in parallelogram. Where, sir? Look at your parallelogram here. Once again, no problem. I will draw it. It is a small thing. Okay. Just a simple one. Quickly, I will draw without wasting the time here. Yeah, it is a small thing. You see there. Okay. It is the parallelogram. Just drawing the two parallel lines here and there. Okay, this is the one, and this is the another one. Two parallel lines for both. Okay, one closed poly, sorry, parallelogram was constructed here. Okay, and then after constructing this parallelogram, once you check there, these two are actually originated from this point, that is theta usually, and this is A bar and it is B bar. Okay, and here what I am saying, Arunanna, the diagonal taken from the same point gives the resultant of addition of vectors. Nothing to explain, you know it. Okay, that's why I'm not interested to explain this part. Yeah, I'm not interested to explain this part. But what about the other diagonal, means this diagonal, the other diagonal? Okay, look at there. If this is theta, anyone knows the angle here, master? In your mathematics, in parallelogram, opposite angles are equal and the sum of adjacent angles is 180. Do you know that? Yes, exactly. Opposite angle, if it is theta, there also at Y it is theta. Sum of the angles at O and X, theta plus phi equals to 180. I think all of you know in your lowest standards. It is a simple basic concept. So here or there, if I ask you the angle, happily I say, sir, this is simply 180 minus theta, sir. Here it is also 180 minus theta, sir. Okay. So check there. This is A bar, theta, angle between them is theta. And here the angle is 180 minus theta. Okay. Even here also. Now look at there, this is towards right. So the black one, I put the symbol towards right, arrowhead. And this is upwards, look at there, I put the arrowhead upwards. Okay, now you check A bar and B bar. This is B bar and A bar. Okay, so A bar and B bar, in order if I take, this is what I explained here, A bar and B bar in order. The diagonal taken from the point in order, not originated from the same point. Look at there, not originated. Okay. Then this is the diagonal taken from here. Is giving us what, sir? We are going to check. This red color diagonal gives what? Either upwards or downwards. That I don't know. So I have to check it. Better I draw with just without arrowhead an ordinary line. Okay. So here I draw one line like this. This line gives you what? Yeah. Value I know. Why? Because the angle is 180 minus theta and Srivatsa. And here its magnitude you are saying already I calculated here. That is A square plus B square minus 2AB cos theta. I know it. Okay. Accepted. But that gives what? Addition of vectors again or else something. I surely say it is not giving the addition of two vectors. Why? Because if you take the diagonal from here, it is not the addition of two vectors. If you take the vector like this, it is the addition of vectors. Am I right? It is the addition of vectors, not the diagonal taken from here. It is not the addition of vectors. So one thing I can say, this is not the addition of two vectors. Blue one is the addition of two vectors. Then red one is what? We are going to check. Okay, then look at here, Nana. This is A bar And if I take like this, this is B bar. Okay, both are in order. But to apply the parallelogram law of vectors, I require both the vectors originated from the same point. For that, what I am doing here, suppose this is A bar, black one, means the top one I draw here. That implies here, the top one, the black one I am drawing here. This is A bar. And how the B bar actually taken like this? Okay, or taken like this here. That one, what I am doing, I am taking the same length. I am not changing the length. Same length here I am taking. This is B bar. Parallel to same length. Parallelly. But look at, I am changing the direction. Quite opposite I am taking. Look at, he gave in the upward direction, but I took in the downward direction. If I take the vector in the downward direction, refer your notes given in basic mathematics tools. It is called as a negative vector. I don't know how many remembered from our basic mathematics tools. Okay. If the direction is reversed of the same magnitude, it is called as the negative vector of the first. I taught this one in the previous, in basic maths, I taught it. Yeah, good, good, good. So I have to write, it is a negative vector of B. That is actually I have to write minus B bar. But keep in mind, Nana, whether it is plus B bar or minus B bar, magnitude remains same. Keep in mind, length remains same. Okay? They are anti-parallel, means negative vector. Their lengths are equal, Nana. So here magnitude of B bar, that is equals to magnitude of negative B bar. Both have the same magnitude equals to B. Means length of this line. Both equal to B. Keep in mind. Then look at, these two are appearing like originating from the same point or not here. If I reverse the direction. Yeah, good. First you reverse the direction. And now you complete the parallelogram. Yes, from the same point. Oh, better I take the black color. Now you take the parallelogram. Okay. You complete like this. A parallelogram. Happily you can complete. Okay. After completing here the parallelogram, now, applying the parallelogram law of vectors, happily I can draw the one what he asked, the red color one, from the same point like this without violating the rules of parallelogram, following the rules of parallelogram, drawing from the same point here, the diagonal taken from the same point. Yeah, is the resultant of these two. Am I right? A bar plus minus B bar. That is A bar minus B bar. I think now you understood. We are going to enter into the subtraction of vectors, not addition. Okay. That comes as subtraction. So this is actually resultant, excellent, resultant. Resultant of whom? A bar and the addition. Parallelogram says only the addition. Addition with a negative vector of B bar minus B bar. A bar plus B bar. That is nothing but what? Simple. I think you can say it. It is A bar minus B bar, which is the subtraction of. Okay, and that two taken from the same point means no need to bother. Directly I can put here the direction like this. Originated from the same point, taken from there, Happily, I put like this. The arrowhead. Is it correct, Nana? Whatever I have drawn there, the arrowhead? Or else to be taken? Ah, yeah, it is correct only. Very good, very good. Then come to here. Here, the diagonal, of course, I am not dictating anything here, okay? Whatever I have drawn there in the parallelogram, constructed parallelogram, the other diagonal taken from here, the other diagonal, here drawn or taken, better we say taken. From the point, better I give the letters here, what are O, X, Y, Z. This time I took the diagonal from Z, not from O. Okay, the diagonal taken from Z. Okay, after reversing the direction of B bar. Okay, the diagonal taken from Z, okay, after reversing this direction, direction of B bar. Okay, is the resultant of subtraction, this one better I write in another color, subtraction of two vectors. Okay, this is the story. That implies R bar in this case equals to A bar plus minus B bar, already I wrote that, better I write directly R bar minus B bar. Yeah, exact. Then no need to ask, already he gave the angle here as theta. So you know the angle there, 180 minus theta. Then put 180 minus theta here, then directly you will get what will be the resultant, already we did there. That implies the magnitude of resultant mod R bar is equals to, directly you can write root of A square plus B square. If the angle between A and B, okay, before reversing is theta, then here this is minus 2AB cos theta. All of you followed this one, Nana, or else to be explained. The magnitude of subtraction of vectors A square plus B square minus 2AB, not plus, minus 2AB cos theta, where theta is what? Theta is the angle between the two vectors when they are originated from the same point. That is the angle. Right, good. This is A square plus B square minus 2AB cos theta resulting. If they ask the direction, happily you can say. Okay, suppose with the A, alpha, if they ask, tan alpha is equals to, according to the concept, I can write. This angle is 180 minus theta. So tan alpha is equals to B sine theta by A plus B cos theta. Why I left the gap here, Nana? I did not substitute anything. B sine theta. Theta means how much I have to put here? 180 minus theta. Very good. 180 minus theta by A plus B cos theta. Cos theta means 180 minus theta. I think all of you followed. Okay. Now tan alpha equals to, you will get the equation. This is B. I think all of you know sine 180 minus theta is plus sine theta. By A plus B cos 180 minus theta is minus cos theta. So A minus B cos theta. All of you followed, Nana? The two, how to find the magnitude and how to find the direction of subtraction of vectors. Yes, this is the formula for subtraction. It is the magnitude and it is the direction. Okay, how to transform? This is the diagram, transformer diagram. Okay, right. Why I wrote B here? Oh, this is not B. Okay, right. This is the subtraction, Nana. Simple. So theoretically, anywhere if you see the questions in the parallelogram constructed with two vectors originated from the same point, okay, one diagonal gives the addition of the two vectors, the other diagonal gives what? If they ask, have you answered the question? The other diagonal gives you the addition of vectors or subtraction of vectors. Very good. Very good. One diagonal gives addition, other diagonal gives subtraction. Okay, so both the diagonals here we measure in the parallelogram. Okay, their lengths, magnitudes we measure, and their directions also we measure. This is subtraction. Okay, regarding the addition and subtraction, if they ask the loss, okay, not loss, L-O-S-S, L-A-W-S, loss, like Newton's loss, here the loss for the addition and subtraction, we try to draw like this. Number one, what are the losses, sir? Okay, loss means what actually things it follows while adding the vectors. So in case of first addition, if I see the addition, loss of addition of vectors, this is again your subject to exam 4 marks question, Nana. Okay, explain the loss of addition of vectors, loss of subtraction of vectors. Okay, not much important for objective. This is only meant for subjective exam. Okay, here, usually in mathematics, shall I write like this, Nana? In the addition of two values, two numbers, like 2 plus 3 is equals to 3 plus 2, any mistake here? Just in mathematics, with the numbers. Is it correct? Obviously correct, no mistake. 2 plus 3 is 5, 3 plus 2 is also 5. Okay. This one in mathematics, they call it as commutative law. Exactly. Okay. This is called as commutative law. That commutative law for numbers, what you said in mathematics, okay, is it valid for vectors also or not? That is the first law. Okay. So first law, we are checking like numbers. Here also it obeys or not. Yes, Siri, we are going to check whether what you posted there, A bar plus B bar, whether it is equals to B bar plus A bar or not. Okay. So here, first I am coming to commutative law. Deepika, this is the commutative law, Nana. Yes, it will be equal. Yeah, yeah. Then we have to check. Means we have to prove it actually. Right? So commutative law means here, for the given two vectors, I write like what I write, A bar plus B bar is equal or not, I don't know, equals to B bar plus A bar. If it follows, then I can say addition of vectors obeys the commutative law. First law I say here for addition of vectors. So for proof, sir, how you prove, sir? This is not so easy. It is not like 2 plus 3 is equal to 3 plus 2. There even the child also can say, 2 plus 3, uncle, it is 5, uncle, 3 plus 2 is also 5, uncle, what? Uncle, what you are asking, 5 equals to 5. Simply they say. Okay, but when you come to vectors, not only the magnitudes, you have to prove that both the addition of a bar plus b bar and b bar plus a bar have the same direction. That is very important when you come to vectors. We have to show that both have same direction, both have same magnitude. Okay, so for that we are just checking here. It is very easy. One, if I say other, you can easily get. Okay. This is a bar. Anisha, nothing, Nanisha. Just we are going to prove a bar plus b bar is whether equal to b bar plus a bar or not. Okay. Not only the magnitude, but also the direction. Both have same direction, both have same magnitude or not. We are checking. Okay, this is, I am taking a bar and that is b bar. Okay, a bar plus b bar means, you know, addition of vectors, very first initial days of this addition of vectors, I already told. Arenana, the open side taken from the very beginning point to very final point, if you join, that gives the resultant of both. A bar plus b bar, like the diagonal. Yeah, not from here, from there. Okay. This red one gives what? Initial to final. This is the very initial point in order. This is the very final point. So the red one gives for us a bar plus b bar. If you ask the length, measure the length with a tape. This is the length, its magnitude. Okay. Now I require what? B bar plus A bar now. Means B bar plus A bar at all. Okay. Now check it here. I'm taking. Very good. A bar is shifted parallel. Am I right? Yes. And B bar also shifted parallel. Very good. Very good. Now B bar first shifted parallelly here. B bar, I'm going to draw a parallel line. This is B bar, the black one, and the blue one, A bar. We are taking the A bar, blue one here, parallel to it. Yes. Oh, forming another two adjacent sides of parallelogram. Exactly, Nana, exactly. What you said is correct. Taking this one. Okay. Right. Now this blue one is A bar. Direction is not equal. Once you check, Nana, Nisha, this is A bar. And this is B bar. Now you start from here. Previously also we started from there only, but towards right we went. This time you go up. Okay. First, what vector, which vector you are getting? First, you are getting B bar. In order, you are getting next followed by A bar. So in order, if you check, this is B bar, this is A bar. So here, if I take one vector from the very initial point to very final point, like this, from very initial point to very final point, okay, better I shift a bit up, just to distinguish only, Nana, to see the two colors, okay. Just shifted a bit up here. Look at the pink one gives you what? The addition of two vectors. Again, addition. But first I took B bar or A bar? At the initial point. First I took B bar. So it is B bar is added with A bar. Added with A bar. Look at both have same length or not? same diagonal, so they have same length, am I right? Their magnitudes are equal. And look at their directions also, you are getting the same, upwards or downwards, both I am getting the directions upwards. Magnitudes and directions are same. Yeah, from the figure I see. Magnitude of A bar plus B bar is equals to magnitude of B bar plus A bar. They are equal. Okay. And their directions also same. They are in the same direction. That's it. Nothing to explain. Hence, you can say here, you can conclude A bar plus B bar is equals to, happily you can write now, is equals to B bar plus A bar. So it obeys the commutative law or does not obey the commutative law, you conclude. Now here, it obeys. Very good. So addition of vectors, I say, addition hence, addition of vectors happily obeys the commutative law. Okay. Then I have to check on the other side simultaneously. Oh, I think time will not be sufficient. Okay, better I try to complete first addition of vector. It is better to discuss both simultaneously, Nana. Addition, loss of addition of vectors and loss of subtraction of vectors, so that we can understand properly. Yes, yes. So better on the other side here, right hand side, I am taking the loss of, the loss of subtraction of vectors. Oh, vectors. Then we check here. Again, I'm coming to commutative law. This one, I think, just in numbers only, I think it does not obey. Is 3 minus 2 equals to 2 minus 3, Nana? No, obviously. 3 minus 2 is nothing but 1. 2 minus 3 is minus 1. Numbers itself in mathematics, they are not obeying the commutative law. Then how can here the subtraction of vectors obey the commutative law? Even though we check. Okay. First, the commutative law. Obviously, we can say why? Because numbers itself, they are not obeying. So here, even the directions, we have to check how they. So directly you can say the first one, if you come to commutative law here, for the given two vectors, okay, I say here A bar plus B bar, of course I know in my mind says is not equal to B bar. Sorry, it is not addition, subtraction. A bar minus B bar is not equal to B bar minus A bar. Before confirming, we have to check. Okay. A bar minus B bar means, look at the diagram, Nana. In this, I think one should be reversed. Okay. So A bar, here B bar, direction I am going to reverse. I take like this. This is A bar. And this is B bar upwards actually. So better I go with the same colors so that you won't get any confusion. This is A bar, blue one as usual, like in the previous diagram. B bar, the black one, I'm reversing the direction like this. Then it becomes plus B bar or minus B bar, Nana? This one? This is A bar and that is minus B bar. Exactly. This is minus B bar. And here, as usual, the diagonal taken from the same point obviously gives the resultant of both. This is the diagonal which gives us what the A bar plus minus B bar, that is minus B bar. Okay, good. One I completed now. Now I require B bar minus A bar nana. So B bar I have to draw in the same direction. Which one? The black one. So better I am drawing the parallel line here. In the same direction. Nana, are you able to follow? All of you are getting confusion in the middle. Sure. Okay, right. Then, okay. Then it is B bar I'm drawing here. Yes, thank you, Nana. This time, yes, Surya, Samhita. A should be reversed. Exactly. B, we have to take the black one in the same direction. Black one, we have to take in the same direction. You should not change. But the blue one, we have to reverse. This blue one, actually taken towards right. This time, I'm taking towards left. Oh, I'm taking towards left. Like this. Yes. Then it should be minus A bar. And that should be B bar plus B bar. Yeah. This time minus A bar plus B bar, both are originated from this point. Previously, those two are originated from this point. Originated from this point means I have to take that diagonal, pink color diagonal. I have to take this time like this. Like in the opposite direction. Okay. Just to distinguish the colors and bit shifting it down. Actually, along the same line. For distinguishing, we are taking it separately, like this. And this pink one is what, Nana? It is B bar minus A bar. But look at from the diagram, I can conclude one point. What, sir? Look at mod of A bar minus... exactly, Srinidhi Priya. Super, Nana. Their magnitudes are equal. Their lengths are equal. Just in opposite direction. Mod A bar minus B bar is equals to mod B bar minus A bar. Their magnitudes are equal. But they are not equal. Reason behind, their directions are in opposite direction. Okay, directions are different. But they are in opposite directions, perfectly opposite directions. Hence, I can conclude what? Addition of vector, subtraction of vectors does not obey. Yes, does not obey. The commutative law. Okay. But shall I say one point here, Nana? Their magnitudes are equal, quite opposite in the direction. So A bar minus B bar, exactly, they are negative vectors. Exactly. A bar minus B bar is the negative vector of B bar minus A bar. Yes. So I'm going to write here, okay, where? On the other side. Better I write here only. But B bar minus A bar is the negative vector of A bar minus B bar. Okay. One la we completed none. Okay. Oh, it's 10:56. So the second la I think I can't complete. So better today I go with the third la. It is easy one. Today I explain the third la, Nana. This is actually distributive law. Second law, tomorrow I will explain. The time is not sufficient to explain. Okay. So distributive law. If you see there, here and there, the third one, distributive law. Tomorrow, once you remind, Nana. Right, exactly. Okay, better instead of A, you take a number like K, okay, some number K. Okay, right. Distributive law means here distributing the things while multiplying with a number. Okay, when addition of vectors. Is multiplied not with a vector, multiplied with a scalar, a number. Scalar means just a number. Okay, then look at, no need to explain, you can understand very easily, like K into A bar plus B bar. If I take addition of vector multiplied with the K. Yeah, it is simple one. No need to explain with any figure. Directly anybody, it is not a vector. It is just a number like 2 into 3 plus 4. Multiplying with a number means directly you can write 2 into 3 plus 2 into 4. Correct, Anana? They are equal. Exactly. They are equal. So happily you can write without any explanation. I think you won't ask explanation for this. K into A bar plus K into B bar. Anyone here asking the explanation for this, Nana? I think not required. No, very good. Not required. Same thing you can write here. Same, just copy paste. When addition, in place of addition, you write subtraction. Subtraction of vectors. Oh, oh. Subtraction of vectors is multiplied with a number. With a scalar. Same just like a number. Just a number. Then, yes, it is also K is a constant. Nana. Then, here I already wrote, Nana, just a number. Okay, just a number. Mr. Balaji. Okay, here I write K into this time A bar minus B bar is equals to just a number. K into A bar, shall I write like this, minus K into B bar? Is it correct, Nana? Even here also, I think you don't want any explanation. Okay. So there and here you can conclude. Hence, it obeys. Distributive law. There also you can conclude finally, hence it obeys distributive law. That's it. Okay, don't get confused, Nana. Here or there, if they give like this, don't get confused. What? Suppose K1 plus K2, these two are just two numbers like 2 plus 3 into A bar is given. Shall I write like K1 into A bar plus K2 into A bar, Nana? They are just numbers only. Again, K1 and K2 are numbers. Yeah, in the same way here, you can write under note. what here k in k1 plus k2, both are just numbers, k1 and k2 are numbers, into, sorry, this time k1 minus k2. K1 minus k2 into a bar is equals to, I think you know how to write, no need to explain. You understood this step. Okay. Yeah. This is coming under distributive, Nana. Any doubts here in today's class, Nana? Do you have no doubts? Okay, right. Shall I stop the class here? Yeah, good.